Hi guys, it's Mrs. Cameron here, taking a look at the CLT math prep. The first place I would want you to look is at cltexam.com. In the upper right corner, you just sign in or sign up and it'll bring you to your dashboard here. You have your option to register to take your CLT exam at home on any of these dates here. And in order to get registered for the test, you would click here. You would have to update your profile, and then you would have to make your payment here. Also on your dashboard, you can see three practice tests. And what I really like about this is that after you take a practice test, you can click here and it'll give you an answer key with not just the answers to every question, but you'll also get the explanation for the answers. So this is very useful to you. I would highly recommend anyone getting ready to take your CLT exam to get to know all three of these practice tests very well. My particular students were only focused on the math. So when I go in to do my practice tests, I'm only looking at the math section. So hopefully as I take the tests more often over time, my score would get higher because I'm studying and getting to know the questions better. So if you click on take test number one, this is what I do. I skip all of section one. I skip all of section two. And I look at section number three. My first thing I do immediately when the timer begins is I click C for every single answer. My students and I decided that this would be our strategy for taking the CLT exam, is to take a minute or a minute and a half to do this. Bum, bum, bum. Click, click, click. Click, click, click. So if you're like me and you're multitasking while you're watching this YouTube video, I hope you're logging on to CLT and clicking C's just like me. I call this with my students, we say, see your way through the test. So immediately when the section begins, you're gonna spend this minute or so at the beginning clicking these, okay? Look at that, just over a minute. And then I come back up to the top. Notice you have your reference sheet here, but when you're on a question, if you want to see the reference sheet, you just click right there and you can see it anytime. I'm not going to do my video from this website. I'm going to come over here to the PDF because I can't write on the screen there. But here I can. So on my PDF, we can take a look at question number 81. It says, what is the value of B in the figure below? Note, the figure is not necessarily drawn to scale. So I can see angle B here is a corner angle in what's that shape? In the triangle. And it doesn't directly state the angle degrees for the other two angles of the triangle, but I can see that this 45 degree angle and this angle over here are vertical angles, and we know from geometry class that all vertical angles are congruent. And over here as well, we're not explicitly given this angle measure, but we were given the vertical angle that is 55 degrees. So we know that this is also 55 degrees. What else do you know about the three angles inside of a triangle? Angle one plus angle two plus angle three has to add up to 180 degrees. So if angle one is 45 degrees, angle B over here, we don't know. And the third angle is 55 degrees. These have to add up to 180. Well, what is 45 plus 55? Five plus five plus four, nine plus one more, 10. So 100 plus angle B equals 180 degrees. And that means that B has to be equal to 80 degrees. And if you'll notice, I wrote out this simple math long ways like this because I'm modeling for you that I want you to write this out on your scrap paper. This test is a no calculator math test. So don't make a mistake on something silly. Make sure that, you know, if you have something that's quick and simple to do, just write it down and show your math. Number 82, a scientist is creating a two chemical solution from the following different chemical substances: chemical A, chemical B, chemical C, and chemical D. Chemical A can be mixed with any chemical except chemical C. Chemical C can only be mixed with chemical D. Which of the following must be true? Okay. Chemical A and B can be mixed. It says chemical A can be mixed with any chemical except C. So that means A and B can be mixed. That must be true. Chemical B and D can be mixed. The stipulations up here don't really say anything about B and D. So this is maybe true, but it's not must be true. So that's not going to be in our answers. So you're out. And you're out. And then number three says chemical B and C can be mixed. But over here it says chemical C can only be mixed with chemical D. So C cannot go with B. So those are out. The only one that is a yes must be true is option one. And then one more quick question for this intro video, number 83. Which point, X, Y, is the solution to the following system of equations? Our solution to a system of equations just means where do the graphs of these two lines intersect? You can solve that by graphing it. If your specialty is graphing, the first line, y equals negative 2x plus 5, my y-intercept is 5. And my slope is negative 2. So I'm going down 2 over 1, down 2 over 1 more, down 2 over 1 more, like this. And, okay, my next equation, we'll go for another color, says 3x plus 2y equals 9. In standard form for our linear equation, I can find my x and y intercepts really fast. So my x-intercept when y is 0, 3x equals 9, so x equals 3. Ooh, that's right here. And my y-intercept when x equals 0, y-intercept 9, 2y equals 9, so 9 divided by 2, y equals 4.5. 1, 2, 3, 4.5. Oh, man. That's kind of a mess. And that's a little bit hard to see. Okay, I can definitely say they're intersecting somewhere between where x is, not when x is 0, it's not the y-intercept, it's not in the negatives, it's somewhere in between 0 and 3. So either C or D. So, okay, graphing didn't work for me on this one, wasn't the fastest way. But I can also solve a system of equations. Number one, I said by graphing them. You can also solve it by substitution. Or you could also solve it by elimination. And those are the three rock stars of solving systems of equations. And since y has already been isolated, it'll actually be really quick for us to solve this by substitution. So I'm going to take this y equals to this and sub it in for the y right here. So that gives us 3x plus 2. And instead of y, I'm writing negative 2x plus 5. Equals 9. And now I just got to combine like terms and solve for x. So I'm going to distribute my 2. 3x plus 2 times negative 2x minus 4x plus 2 times plus 5 plus 10 equals 9. 3x minus 4x is negative x. And I can get rid of this plus 10 real quick by subtracting it on both sides of my equal sign. So negative x equals 10, 9 minus 10 is negative 1. So positive x would be equal to positive 1. So I found my answer here by substitution. And stay tuned with some other videos for me on CLT math practice if you found this to be helpful to you. Bye.